to me now. Because it's been over 10 years alone. A long time. And he said that me, him, and Brother Roy went to sleep in the church. And at the time, I heard what he said. But I didn't see no understanding what he was saying. Matter of fact, I don't even know if he saw an understanding about the dream. But when I got up to New Bethel Sunday, and the first preacher stood up and he preached. And I told him that I was glad that he didn't go so far and step over to what I wanted to say. I do remember that much.
That's right.
But the Lord showed me that Peter, James, and John went to sleep. Just like some of us today, we come to church, but we're sleeping. And the whole time, God is trying to show us something. And the more I began to think about that sermon, I had to call around, what happened, what happened? And I got some response, but I still didn't get the full answer to what I needed. And last Sunday, Elder, in your sermon you said, wake up.
Yes, sir.
And I thought about that, I said, did they tell him what took place over there in New Bethel? Because I do remember telling the church to wake up.
That's right.
Sometimes we get too comfortable in God's house.
All right, preacher.
Sitting there with our eyes wide open.
Yeah.
Come on, preacher.
Too comfortable.
Yeah.
And sleep.
Well.
Well, what do you mean? I'm watching you preach. I'm listening to what you're saying, but your mind is all over town.
All right. Yes, sir. All
right. Your mind is on something that it has no business being on beside the Word of God.
Yeah.
And you find yourself going right back home, sleep.
Come on.
Ain't got nothing. Because I fell asleep in the church with my eyes wide open.
Go on.
And God said to the church to wake up. I'm trying to show you something, but you're falling asleep on
me. Madam.
Yes, you have been faithful about coming to church every Sunday.
Yeah.
You've been faithful about serving on the boards, but you have fallen asleep.
Yeah.
Come on now.
You're going about trying to establish your own righteousness. Instead of the righteousness of God.
All right now.
He's telling the church to
wake up.
So the more I thought about this, I said, Lord, what can I put together with this? And the more I thought about it, he said, Moses wanted to see. And scripture says that God talked to Moses face to face.
Yeah.
To me, that meant they had a personal relationship.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
I come to your house, you come to my house. And we sit down and commune with one another. I may meet you down at Burger King like some of the fellas do. And we commune with one another. We have a personal relationship with one another. And all this talking that God and Moses had between each other. Moses asked him one day, I want to see you. Show me your glory. have a relationship, but there's something more about you, God.
Yeah.
That I want to see for myself.
My Lord.
I know we have talked together, we have prayed, but I want to see something different about you. Lord, show me your glory. God, the Lord said, no man has ever seen me and me.
Come on, preacher.
He said, but Moses, let me tell you something. There is a place.
Going on now.
There is a place that if you hang out with me long enough.
Yeah.
Hang with me long enough.
That's all right.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
If you don't get tired of me, show me what to do when you follow my commandments.
Look.
Hang out with me long enough.
Yeah.
There is a place beside me.
That's right.
I know it, I know.
Glory.
God said there's a place beside.
Thank you.
And sometimes we be walking with God.
Uh-huh.
And we almost at that place with God.
Yeah.
But disobedience caused us to turn away from God.
Yeah.
And we were at the verge of being in the place.
Uh-huh.
But he would hide you.
Yeah.
That's all right.
That's all right.
He said, but there is a place that I want you to go to.
Yeah.
He said, come up just a little bit high.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. There's a rock.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
That I want you to stand upon.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Yes, sir.
And when I pass by.
Uh-huh.
My goodness.
Yes.
I'm gonna allow you to see my goodness.
Yes.
My
goodness. Yes.
My goodness.
Yes.
I'm gonna allow you to see my goodness.
Yes.
Wow.
When I pass by you.
Uh-huh.
He said, but I'm gonna put my hands up.
Yes.
In front of your face.
Yes,
uh-huh.
Sir. Yes, sir.
But let me deal with that goodness a little bit, because David said something about that goodness.
Yes, sir.
David said, goodness and mercy.
Yes.
It's something. It's something that's following me all.
David
said, my
life. Yeah.
That's what David said.
Uh-huh.
Y'all said, but my goodness.
Hey, hallelujah.
Everything I showed you in the past.
Uh-huh.
That was my goodness.
Yeah.
The pillow at night.
Yeah.
That was my goodness.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
The cloud by day.
Yeah.
That was my goodness.
Yeah.
When I opened up the Red Sea.
Yeah.
That was my goodness.
Yeah.
When the east wind blew.
Yeah.
That was still my goodness.
Yeah.
He said, but since you want to see something.
Going on.
You can't see it when you're sitting there. That's what I'm getting ready to tell the church. You can't see it when you're sitting there.
My Lord.
You're a little bit too low right now.
Yeah. No.
You got to come up just a little bit higher.
Yeah.
You got to come up just a little bit higher.
Because
God got something he wanted to show you because his goodness.
Yeah.
It's about ready to take over St. Luke number 2.
We're going on.
Because our minds is too low.
Yeah.
His goodness can't come up in him.
Yeah.
He said, come up just a little bit
higher.
He said, I got something I want to show you.
Yeah.
Then the more I thought about this situation,
uh-huh.
I can see Jesus now in my mind.
Yes.
Going up the Mount Transfiguration.
Yes.
He said, come on, boys. I can see no water. I got all I want to say. That you ain't never seen. You done seen me lay hands on the sick.
Yeah.
You done seen me raise
hands.
Go on, Pastor McSween.
This afternoon, if you can just walk with me just a little while longer.
Yeah.
And I can see them going on up to the mountain.
Yeah.
The higher they got.
Yeah.
The tighter they got.
Yeah.
see him and Brother Walker went to sleep.
Yeah.
I can see him going to sleep on Jesus.
Yeah.
But they were about to miss out on the best thing.
Yeah.
That ever happened to him.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
I'm about to go on now to the Garden of Gethsemane.
Yeah.
And when I get to the Garden of Gethsemane,
yeah,
I find the same three boys sleeping in.
Yeah.
Jesus walked away from us and woke him up and said,
stay away for a few minutes. Yes.
And he woke him up that time.
Yeah.
And then when he went back up,
he preaching tonight.
Jesus went just a little bit up.
Yeah.
Sometimes in life, you got to go just a little bit up.
Yeah.
And he said, he turned around and he found him sleeping in.
Yeah.
And he woke them and touched them one more time.
Yeah. Yeah.
Go on.
Yes, sir.
That's what Jesus said.
Hallelujah.
He walked away again.
Uh-huh.
Yes, the Bible said, when he walked away this time,
yeah,
he went just a little bit further.
Uh-huh.
But when he came back,
oh, yes, indeed,
he woke him up again.
Uh-huh.
But what stuck out in the mind,
uh-huh,
when he began to talk to him, he said, sleep on.
Sleep on.
Just as Jesus said, sleep on.
Yeah.
Sleep on.
Yeah.
But then the rest of the time said, get up now.
Yeah.
My time is right there. The glory of the Lord.
Yeah.
We're about to build this place.
Go on.
We're about to go and sleep and miss out on the greatest blessing that the hell has.
Yeah.
That's why I told the church Sunday, we got to wake up.
Yeah.
We got to wake up.
Yes.
We got to wake up.
Yeah.
We can't see what God wants for us.
Yeah.
We fall asleep. We got to wake up, church.
Hey.
No finish. No finish. It's something about His glory.
Yeah.
That God is trying to show it to us. I'm not finished.
Look.
God is trying to show us glory. We fall asleep on God's glory.
Yeah.
We fall asleep on God's glory.
We got to cover His face.
We fall asleep on God's glory. We fall asleep on God's glory.
Yes, sir.
Woo.
We fall asleep on God's glory. Anything that's not right, will be burned up.
Yes, sir.
Yes, he will.
But he calls that a purge.
Yes,
got him.
Thank
you,
Lord.
Thank you, God.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, God. Are you worthy to be praised?
Yes, Lord.
And we honor you and we magnify you.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, there's nobody like you. God, you heal the sick.
Oh, yes, you did.
And you have raised the dead.
Yes, you did.
God, and just your word. If you say live, we got to live.
Yes, sir.
If you say die,
yes, sir.
We got to die.
Yes, sir.
But Lord, if you deliver us,
yes, sir.
We know we shall be delivered.
Yes, sir.
And God, if you heal us,
yes, sir.
We know we shall be healed.
Oh, yes, sir.
God bless now.
Yes, sir.
Let your glory,
glory.
Shake up Darwin Heights.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Yes, Lord.
Turn it upside down.
Yes, Lord.
Do it, Lord.
Like never before.
All right.
And for the ones that's sitting here today, God,
Lord, yes,
Lord. Lord.
Turn some things upside down in their life.
Lord.
Do it.
They may call on you evermore.
Yes.
That we may walk in your glory.
Yes,
Lord.
God, we thank you.
Thank you.
Matter of fact, God, let your glory,
yes, Lord,
go to the hospital.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
hallelujah.
Go to our members' houses.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Do it.
That's sick.
Do it.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Let the power of your glory,
yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Move right now.
Right,
yes,
now.
Lord.
Right now, Lord.
Let your power and your glory,
yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Move right now.
Right
now.
Hallelujah.
The doctors may have given up.
Yes, Lord.
But when your glory enters into that room,
yes, Lord.
It's going to make a difference.
Yes. Amen.
Lord, yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
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 Amen. Lord, yes, Lord.
Amen.
Lord, yes, Lord.